Welcome. My name is Marc Shipman-Mueller, and I'm a product manager at ARRI. You're watching one in a series of ARRI Tech Talk videos that explain the features of the Alexa 35. I am assuming that you have already watched the Alexa 35 guided tour video to get an overview of the camera. If you've not, please do so, because in this video here, we will go more into detail. Specifically about the new creative options provided by the Alexa 35, the wide range of available lenses, the new ARRI textures, and the new look handling. Let's start with a lens choice. We've developed a new sensor for this camera, which I have right here. This is a native 4K sensor. It has 4.6K photo sites across that runs up to 120 frames a second. The physical dimensions of the sensor are almost the same as the Alexa Mini sensor. It is a Super 35 sensor. Because of that, it supports all Super 35 and large format lenses, modern or vintage, anamorphic or spherical, with large or small image circles. And it does that while fulfilling all 4K mandates. Really all, you may ask? Yes, it does. Most streamers require that you have the same number of photo sites on the sensor as there is in 4K UHD. Now, 4K UHD is 3840 by 2160, so if you multiply 3840 by 2160, you get 8.29 megapixels. As long as you have 8.29 megapixels on your sensor, you're fine, you're fulfilling the 4K anamorphic mandate. Our 3.3K 6x5 recording format, which is what you would use for anamorphic shooting, has 10 megapixels, so you're totally fine. If you need any more, you can always shoot open gate and create your own 3.8K 6x5 custom frame line, and that is 12 megapixels, enough for anybody. So whatever lens you want to use, this camera has got you covered. Our next cool feature are the ARRI textures. Cinematographers have asked us often to give them more control over the image. Now, in all ARRI digital cameras, there are 30 image processing steps that happen even before ARRI RAW, and they determine the texture of the image. In the past, we have set those to default values for what we consider the best cinematic image with the best texture. So, what is a texture? These settings determine the contrast at different levels of detail, which for the more technically inclined is the MTF curve, as well as the amount and the character of the grain. Since this is an in-camera process, textures are always baked into ARRI RAW and ProRes. With the new Alexa 35 texture files, you can now go beyond these default settings. An ARRI texture file is a sensible combination of these 30 image settings. ARRI textures can be chosen in camera like choosing an ARRI look file or like you would have chosen a film stock in the old days. And the camera comes with several ARRI textures pre-installed. There are different textures designed for different shooting situations. One for skin tones, one for night shoots, and so on. Since ARRI textures are in camera, they're always baked into ProRes and ARRI RAW. Now, if all this freaks you out, you can just use the default texture, and then you get what you would have gotten if there was no texture feature. We recommend that you test and choose an ARRI texture in pre-production, just like you would test and choose a show LUT. ARRI textures can be viewed on the viewfinder and on the SDI output. ARRI textures can be very subtle, so they're best viewed on a large, high-quality HDR screen in pre-production, so you can really see what you're going to get. Here are three examples of ARRI textures. We're going to zoom in a little bit, since some of you may be watching this on a small screen. On the left is always the default texture, and on the right is the nostalgic texture right now. This has a vintage feel, with more grain and a softer character. The grain is also desaturated, based on direct feedback from cinematographers. Next, we have the high-clarity texture. This is a texture with increased sharpness and increased detail. And then the third one is the cosmetic texture. It is a softer texture specifically designed for skin tones. ARRI textures is a new and exciting feature, and we're very curious to see how you are going to use them and what new textures you would like to see in the future. Now, the next feature in terms of the new creative options is the new look handling. And there are three features within that that improve the way you handle a look. There's a new log-to-log look file format, there's the ability to set the look intensity on set, and there's a built-in log-c4 look library. Now let's look at the new log-to-log file format. This is something we've observed in post-production for a while and then decided to bring to the camera. What the log-to-log file format does is it separates the creative intent on one hand to the conversion of a display color space on the other. Now, I know that's a mouthful, so let me break this down and explain it by first starting with our existing look file, the ALF2 look file, that we're using in our existing cameras. So let's say you're starting with a Log C3 image without the look, and you want to get to a Rec 709 image with the look. With the ALF2 look file, you have the creative intent. Let's say the director says he wants it moody, and so we need to make the image a little more blue. And then the conversion to the display color space, and both of those are packed into one look file. This functioned great for a while, but once HDR started to come along, this became a little problematic because now you needed two different look files, one for SDR and one for HDR. So what the new look file does is we're only using the creative intent and we're going from log to log. So we're starting with the log C4 image from the Alexa 35 without the look, then we have the look file, and as a result, we have a log C4 image with the look. The conversion to the display color space is then done in a separate step, either by the camera on set or by the post house in post. The advantage of this is that on the set, you can view one look either in SDR or in HDR, and in post, you have easier grading based on the creative look chosen on set, since you do not have to try to remove the conversion to the display color space. This is also a future-proof file format. Displays and display color spaces will change, but the creative intent is safe in the log-to-log file standard. Next, let's talk about setting the look intensity on set. This is also something we've seen in post. Clients would come into the grading suite, they would create a look, then they would go to lunch, come back, view the look, and say, you know, let's just dial this down a little bit. I like the look, but I want just a little bit less. We're giving you this ability also in the camera. So the look intensity is how much of the look is added to the log C4 image. 100% intensity is the look fully applied, and 0% intensity is just the log C4 image. The Alexa 35 always records log C for ARRI RAW and for ProRes without any looks baked in. But the look is always recorded in metadata, and the chosen look intensity is also recorded in metadata. This is so dailies can be made with the same look and the same look intensity as you saw on set. And last but not least, we have the Log C4 Look Library. The Look Library was a very popular feature with the Alexa Mini. It is included free of charge in the Alexa 35. However, we've upgraded it to account for the reveal color science and the new Log C4 tonal curve. So in summary, with the Alexa 35, we're giving you more creative options with a wide range of available lenses, the new ARRI textures, and the new look handling. Thank you so much for watching.